Hello students, I welcome you all for computer science class. Let us continue chapter 1. The topic is types of computer language. Let us see the different types of languages are low level languages, high level language and artificial intelligence. So these first low level languages having the period of 1942 to 1964. So, which is able to known as the first and second generation of computers. So, the low-level languages able to calculate the data in the form of zeros and ones. The computer doesn't know to read the letters, words or sentence. So, it automatically converts the data into zeros and ones, which is called as machine-readable form. Then, come to third generation and fourth generation. Look at the year of this fourth generation. It started from 1964 to 1980. So these high level languages is known as third and fourth generation. So here when compared to the first generation, which is in low level language, somewhat improved in the machine, computer machine. It is very portable. Likely we can able to move wherever we want. And also able to process very fast and accurate result. So here they can used as slowly as high level languages. So then come to fifth generation. The fifth generation is known as started from 1980 to in future. Till date and future. What is that? It will best example we can say that a robot. So artificial intelligence is under the fifth generation of computers. So let us see the chapter detail and mark your questions and one marks in your book itself. Let us continue the types of computer language. Under this, we will see the first subtopic, low level language. This low level language also called as machine language. What does mean by machine language? The machine language able to have only two digits. One is zero, another one is one. Only two digits. So it is also called as binary numbers. So what is meaning of bi? Bi means two. What is the meaning of bi? Bi in mathematical term, bi means two. So this machine readable language having only two possible numbers. One is zero, another one is one. So this is called as low level language. So this computer able to read the values only in the form of binary. Whatever the value you are typing from the keyboard, that typed value is converted into binary form. Let's see an example. Suppose you are typing letter A from the keyboard. So every character set in the keyboard having ASCII code system, which is nothing but each set in the keyboard having a particular number. For example, small a having a ASCII code number is 97. This is generally followed by every computer. So what is the value of a for ASCII code? 97. So this particular number 97 is divided by 2. Why it is able to divide it by 2? Because it is converted into binary number system. I already told you bi means 2. So only 2 possible numbers. So that's why this particular number 97 is divided by 2. If you have any remainder, put 1. If you don't have any remainder, put 0. For example, I am typing a letter A from the keyboard. So what the computer will do? The computer processor automatically that value is the typed value from the keyboard is transferred into binary form. What step it can do? So it will take the action that particular word or number or letter is divided by 2. Let's see if you are typing A. So it automatically takes the ASCII value as 97. So 2 all divide pananum. So 2. So 4 2s are 8. So 8 is there. 9 minus 8, 1. 8 2s are 16. 17 minus 16, I have a remainder 1. Then 2 2s are 4. 4 2s are 8. There is no any remainder. Put 0. Again, divided this number by 2. So 1 2 is 2, 2 2 is 4, there is no remainder, put 0. Again 2. 6 2s are 12. There is no remainder. Put 0. Again 2. 3 2s are 6. There is no remainder. Put 0. Again 1 2 is 2. So 3 minus 2, 1. So put the remainder 1 here. How it is able to write? It is able to write in the form of top to bottom. Okay. So you have to write the binary values from bottom to top. Not top to bottom. From bottom level to top level. So 1 1 here. So what is the A value in binary form means? So you can start writing from bottom level. So 1 1. Again, how many zeros? 1 2 3 4. Put 4 zeros. Again 1. So this is the value of A in binary form. So this type of conversion method the processor can do. So this type of conversion is called as machine language. Understood? Which is also called as low level language. Students, suppose if it is small A97 is started as ASCII code, then what about B? The next number will be follows for B. So 98, for C 99, up to small Z is 122. So smaller letter is differ from capital letter for a computer. It is not same. So the ASCII values also changes. So what is the capital letter A? Which ASCII code is 65, B as 67, C as B as 66, C as 67, and last final Z value is 90. So all these values are represent for the alphabetical order or even numbers. For the number system, so zero. So in our keyboard, you can take the number as 0 to 9. So the ASCII value of 0 is 48. Okay, students. Then 1 is 49. Number 2 is 50. So suppose if you type number 1 from the keyboard, so 1 takes the ASCII value as 49. Likewise, it is divided and converted into this binary form. Okay, so this is the method of transferring normal values to binary form. So what does mean by ASCII code? It is designed by the Americans. So ASCII means American Standard Code for Information Interchange. So this is a simple method used to convert machine readable language. Next we can see assembly language. This assembly language is also one of the software program. How it is able to work in a machine readable language? This assembly language is a programmer. It is able to work with English language. Look at the example I have given. So this is the few example of assembly language. From the word ADDAD, we know how to read this. So it is a simple English word added to this assembly language. But in machine readable code, it is full and fully depend only zeros and ones. But assembly language, somewhat it will add a few English letters or English word. So this is some instruction is given by the user. So add, subtraction. No, you don't want to write full name as a subtraction. It will take only SUB. SUB means we understood it is a subtraction. Moving. So R4 value is moved to another variable called as RAX. Somewhat cut and copy. So these are the simple assembly language with help of assembler able to convert into machine language. Assembly language is also converted as machine language with the help of assembler. What does this assembler means? It is a translator that translates a program written in an assembly language into machine language. This is one of the software instruction able to convert this assembly language into machine language. If you are typing some assembly language in your computer, with help of this assembler, assembler is a software instruction able to convert this assembly language into machine readable form. Now we can move on to the third part, high level language. What is the definition of high level language? It is full and fully depends upon English words. See, it is mostly the user able to give English words and mathematical operations. both English words and mathematical operations are mingled to work as a computer programming language, which is able to process very easily, and also we can able to learn very easily. Let's see some example. This is a C++ program. Look at this. This is integer value main. So we have given some a value, b value. It is an integer type. Integer means whole number. Okay. So a and b having a value 20. Sorry, a having a 10 and b is having a 20. So I am going to add these two numbers. C is equal to a plus b. Then I am going to print the value of c. We know the c value is 30. From we can see the example, we come to understand the C value as 30. So the C value is able to print by using this particular print function. Okay, so look at this example. We easily able to learn. So that is why it is called as high level language. We know that it is integer, it is main. The value of A is 10, the value of B is 20. We can able to read very easily. This is print. We are printing the output variable called as C. So we can able to read very easily. Okay, this high level language is also converted into machine readable form with the help of compiler. In assembly language, with the help of assembler only, we are able to convert assembly language into machine language. But in high level language, with help of compiler, we are converting the instruction given by the user through the computer with help of compiler. It is converted into machine readable form. What is the definition of compiler? It is another type of translator. Either translate panadhu. So this particular instruction is translated into machine readable form. It is an another type of translator. It is used to convert this high level language. This is an example of high level language into machine readable code. So compiler is also one of the software instruction. Okay children, it is one of the software instruction able to convert this high level language into machine readable form. Then the last topic is artificial intelligence. It is based on the fifth generation, that which means in future. Best example we can say for a robot. The robot is also programmed like a human beings, able to walk, able to talk, their own natural languages likewise. So artificial intelligence is the best example is robot. Then come to translator. So how this translator works? So source code with help of the translator converted into machine code. What is mean by source code? Whatever the user able to type in the computer with the help of a keyboard, then any type of translator, for example I told you assembler and compiler, any type of translator able to convert that source code into machine readable code. What is machine readable code? Everything is converted into zeros and ones, which is called as machine readable code. What are the different types of translator? Assembler, compiler, and also we have interpreter. Interpreter is also another type of translator able to convert high level language into machine language. This interpreter is also work as in high level language. This interpreter is also works under high level language. This type of high level language with help of compiler as well as interpreter convert this high level language into machine readable language. Students, let's see the one mark now. Just we can mark in your book itself. Fourth generation computer uses a microprocessor. So microprocessor is one of the main component used in the fourth generation. Put tick mark in the box. Which of the following can execute billions of instructions per second? So billions of instruction able to performed by mainframe computers. So the binary number system use only how many digits? Only two digits. What is there? Zeros and ones. Okay students. Okay. C, C++, C hash are the types of high level languages. So C, C++ are the examples of high level languages. What are compiler and interpreter and assembler? These are the types of language translators. Now we can see Philips, CDC 1700 and HP 3000 are examples of microcomputers. These are called as a computers, name of the computers. So belongs to microcomputer. An example of a system running with artificial intelligence. So best example is robots. The language that is directly understood by the computer is called as machine language. Suppose if we can give assembly language or we can able to give high level language, computer understood only machine language. It translates into machine readable form, that is zeros and ones. The language processor that translate into a program in high level language. What are the user given in a high level language, the compiler able to translate into machine readable form. So answer is compiler. Now come to and match the following. Artificial intelligence. So it belongs to the fifth generation type of computers. Microprocessor. It is belongs to fourth generation computers. Transistors. It is second generation computers. Vacuum tubes. We know that it is first generation computers. The last one, integrated circuits. This is belongs to third generation computers. Okay students, up to this you can mark in your book. The remaining part will continue in the next session. Thank you so much.